So we are back. We're gonna kick some ass. Alright. Gonna get some music ready. Gonna get some music ready. Okay, we're gonna still gonna do that. So far, so good on the music. It ain't too bad. Yeah, so this is Japan Droids. And it's pretty fucking awesome, dude. I'm like, at least her first song's coming with the hotness. and just switch to the what you call it, Orbs Crack brush, so we can get a different type of feel to the creasing, so that we don't use the same brush that we used for the tears. Because if we do that, then our wrinkles are going to look like tears, right? So we have to use different brushes for different things. Alright, so let's see. Alright, that is a real geometry. I'm gonna use the Orbs Crack again. And do that, and then soften this top edge with a standard brush. And a little bit more subtle. And here we're just going to hit this with an opacity map, so we don't even need to take any we don't need to take any geometry away. We don't need to actually model it with an opacity map. Artify this up a bit and turn symmetry back on, get my move, and see if I can make this look a little bit more appetizing. Go. shorten this side up. I'm going to go. Oh, did I accidentally duplicate it? Oh, no, I got it. Okay. Then go down to a lower subdivision level because I don't want to actually mess with the wrinkles that I've done. Let's see if we can. Okay, on this one we're gonna go. Okay, properties double. There we go. Now we can see it. So I was like, "What can I not show you? Is it not long enough?" And then add a little isometry to it, right? So. And just gonna take into account. All right, so we're just gonna start posing this guy. Be pretty simple. He's pretty easy since we have him at a very low base. I'm not gonna worry about rotating this arm. I'm just gonna bend it like this one. I'm just gonna kind of rotate it into place, rotate it forward. But I'm not gonna worry about maintaining any of that like rotational aspect of it, because when we present it, we're going to present it like this, right? So what I'm going to do is go to T-Pose Mesh, so that's in Z Plugin, Transpose Master, and T-Pose Mesh. So before I do that, what I'm going to do is go all low, just a habit that I have from having a less powerful computer, but it does make it go faster. So what it's going to do is it's going to send everything down to its low subdivisional level, and then it's going to make a new subtool, right, out of it, separate by itself, and now you can affect everything at once. So before it was all separate subtools, and now it's all together, right? So this is I enjoy this for like global word I'm looking for. Jesus, what's the word I'm looking for? Like where I need to adjust the shape and it's going to affect more than one object. I like having it like this. In T-Pose Mesh. Alright, so the shoulder actually rotates from here, right? Or wait, actually right around. Put this arm down. He looks like remember that Saturday Night Live where with Kristen Wiig, and it was with all the like really pretty sisters that were singing, and then she would come out and she would have this huge forehead and like baby hands. That's what this reminds me of. Alrighty, so I'm Before I do any of this, this is easy to review than knowing, but I've been taking over all. Make sure these things are proportionally set. And I'm gonna give my end to JMS. Or nest glass, so it's what I want. There we go. And this is a glasso. Alrighty, so we are going to press W, we're going to press X because we do want it to be in symmetry. We're going to use local symmetry, so it grows from its center or from the cursor and not from not globally, so it doesn't just like go off into the distance, because we don't have this on. It'll just do that, right? We don't want that. We want it to grow right here, right? We're just gonna go here and move these things around, and this is where move topological really comes into play. Right, we gotta make sure we're only affecting one subtool at a time. That's fine. These tans definitely could be bigger. Again, click that little widget, make sure local symmetry, visible symmetry is on, and we can make these hands a little bit bigger. Right, there we go. Next, I want to do this after it's posed, because this could be a big old pain. Alrighty, so we don't want like a straight line going from here to here. We want to make it look, you know, a little bit more dynamic than that. Alright, this got boring. Nope. You don't come out sucking on a record, do you? Be real. You know, Alrighty, so we're gonna get the dish noggin. And we're gonna mask that. Oops. And hold control and click the masked area or the unmasked area, it doesn't matter. But it's going to feather that. And we can select all this and then press Control Shift A. I'll do this. So we know from our lectures that the rotation point is not just in the center of the head, but it is actually here on the inside on the base of the skull, like roughly right here under the earlobe. Not really feeling it. So we're gonna go to the art party. Oh yeah! Fuck yeah, bro! Oh, Pulsinator! Fucking feel the metal. Fucking feel it. Your fucking soul. Yes. It's time to party. This down. Oops. I was just so concentrated on the metal, I forgot to unmask that area. May the gods of metal forgive me. We'll figure out this pose as we go along. It's not a one and done type thing. It's just like the rest of the character, you know, we gotta sketch it all in. See what's working, see what's not working, readjust.
But just never fucking give up. It's not the metal way. This is so metal, I don't even know if it's the same song or not. I just know it's metal.
Damn. Again, not concerned with keeping it true to the shoulder, right? Like, I only sketched in this stuff. I don't want it to collapse in on itself, because that's going to be way harder to fix. So just nudging it, but totally just going to bend it right from here and then readjust it to make it look like the bicep.
Fucking metal. Fucking metal.
Just gonna smooth all this out and bring it back out. Oh wait, 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 I don't wanna do that. Yeah, I do, I don't give a shit. I can fix it later. And play. Smooth, and plate. And I'm just gonna hold this right now. He's got the big Arnold arm. Yes, it's good. Very nice. It's not flabby. It's very muscular here. Very nice. It definitely works out. See what I'm talking about? See, that's professionalism right there, dude. That's fucking professionalism. Whew. I know what else y'all want from the stream, dude. I mean, if you haven't subscribed, why haven't you? Like, you nerd or something? Like, not a good nerd, like a bad one. Like the unappreciative type, you know what I'm saying, dude? I'm just saying, dude, just throwing that out there. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna grab this, grab that, oops, grab that, oop, grab that, and grab that, invert it, and get rid of this side. So, mask that, bring everything back, unmask it, and I'm gonna kind of pose this, and then try to fit the leg to it. And I'm holding Alt to move this cursor here, and I'm going to try to get it right around where the ankle would be. And so he's got it like this. I'm going to actually stand up. Oh, okay, good. I'm actually going to stand up in this position. And no, you can't see, alright? What's up, Fernandos? Right, so, let's see. So it's gonna be leaning forward. Alright, it's gonna be leading forward. Heel's gonna be pretty much where the end step is. It's gonna come out a bit. Come out just a bit. And the heel's gonna be where the end step is. And then we're gonna unmask everything else. And we're gonna mask that so we don't affect it whenever we do this move. BMB. Bring this, I'm gonna turn up. Oh. Right, there we go. So, get my brush size, get in that weird. And then just put this sucker up in, meow! And then, fix all this other stuff. So, I'm gonna get rid of that. And, get rid of that. Because I don't want to affect that. What I'm doing is basically just rotating the hip. And, I'm gonna dip the hip as well. Get rid of that. We're gonna add that to the jacket as well. So I'm gonna invert that. And I'm gonna dip that one. Get rid of that arm. Mask this arm by holding control. Inverting it. And picking that up. Laying that down a bit, just so we can really sell that. See that, how it's tilting, right? And then to sell the rest of it, we need to, so as the hips are dipping that way, then we need the shoulder to be this way, and that to be going up, right? We got boom, boom, and then, yeah, that's good. Alright. And next thing we're gonna do is give it a nice little lean over here. And looking pretty sick. Sick, 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 yeah. Fucking metal and sick, yeah. Alright, so. Get rid of that, 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 get rid of that. Burning it. Passing it. Bringing everything back. Got a new brush. Oops. A little too aggressive, you know. A little too aggressive. Alright, and now I have symmetry. I'm gonna try to find a little balance because I kind of want them. Oops, that's a reason. Kind of want them leaning forward, or at least slightly hip, you know, leading with the hips. And then maybe also. Lean them forward a bit. Just a bit. So it's still lined up, right? And we can actually move. God damn, I can't believe my fucking... There we go. What was I gonna do with this? Yeah, we gotta straighten that leg out just a little bit. And just going through here, and now that I've adjusted everything, I'm gonna go through here and just like adjust the forms, kind of bring them back. The major warping they've gone through. I'm not worried about this being perfectly circular. I think it actually has more character if it's not.
There we go, brothers and sisters of metal.
Okay, so we gotta move that arm a little bit closer. So, mask that. And bring it in.
Get this metal on, brother.
There we go. And this. Oops. Move it in place.
Fucking material everywhere.
Alright, there we go. So we've roughly got stuff in place. He's got pictures of my Batman and... God, ugh. Made some mistakes, some sculptural mistakes in here. On the face, but... or maybe that's just a... Oh, that's, yeah, I probably did. Alrighty. Okay, so we're back. Looking at some photos. Alright, so we're gonna bring this down. You can see it's kind of meeting the, whatchamacallit? The, this belt here. Sorry, I got things on my mind, peeps. I got things on my mind! If it's too much, we can adjust it later. Not worried about things. See, and just relax while I'm sculpting. Not worried about it. Right? Get that going. Let's get this angle correct. Seems like it falls off a little bit sooner. Mine looks like he's, looking out a bit too much, and this guy's a little flabby, yes. This man is flabby. He probably only does like 2 push-ups a year. Oh man, I hate it when non-artists try to tell me what things look like. When people with no eye for anatomy, no eye whatsoever, trying to tell me what a sculpt looks like. It's like, dude. No, dude. It's whatever, dude. This is the reason I don't do customs anymore, man. Because these people have no idea, like, quality. Like, they only have a certain amount of money they can do, and they're figuring things out, and they don't know the process, and things are gonna suffer, and it's like, I'm not doing it anymore, dude. Only professional companies have been doing it for years and years and years and years. I can't associate myself with this type of work. Because for the rest of this sculpture's life, it's gonna be referred to as Spicer's Batman, and it's gonna have all these mistakes in it that I've been mentioning from the very beginning. And I'm gonna have to defend myself with all these people that have never chosen to speak to me before. They're now gonna start speaking to me because they want to shit on my sculpt. It's just like, no, dude, my sculpt's solid. Fucking solid. The print, the way it came out, that's what's fucked up. Never, ever, ever again will I do a custom. Never. People just like, you got, oh man, you got like business people in charge of art, dude, and I'm just, It's wrong. Alrighty, anyway. Sorry to bring the stream down, guys. Just can't stand that. And I'm just returning this to the cylindrical nature that it was in before. Alrighty. Man, I'm just getting more and more depressed about that Batman. Oh man, I feel like I just wasted my talent on that shit.
That's badass.
I like that song. Never Never Land by Annihilator. I like metal when it's got a, you know, it's got a sense of humor, you know, like the serious metal, like sweaty metal, you know, like, yeah, I don't know. I think this is roughed in pretty well. Maybe bring this out. I'm gonna. That out a little bit. Yeah, I kind of like at a deeper degree for sure. So we need a little tip of the cap. So gonna have a little curve to the wrist, can't just be straight like that. So I think what I'm gonna do is mask that, rotate it, and then kind of rotate this into place roughly, and then fit the arm into it. Oops. What the fuck is this guy? I don't know. Let's look at terminal redo vector. See how they fare. Something like that. Thinking. And absolutely not. Absolutely not. This fix. I need to calm down, man. For that, I'm gonna send. Well, loading this up, so we're gonna do. Joker face and open mouth. Get rid of this cape. I can't believe I have to do this. Like, see, this is like why you don't work with people who aren't professional. You have to go there and you have to prove yourself. Like, you can't just be taken, you know? It's just like, shit. Maybe that's just too soft for them to get. It's just too soft. It's too subtle. It's my fault. Especially with the cut line that they have in there, it just breaks it. I mean, there's no way around it since they have this cut line here. Like, this is just so fucking dull, man. It's just like so round. This line's not round. There's a flat edge there, and maybe it's just not pronounced enough. I don't know. So I'm just going to get this picture for a second. It just doesn't look like the same nose. I mean, that's not the same nose. I mean, look, there's no plane change. Like, that's all fucking dull. Like, there's even wrinkles in the nose that aren't there. Like, every detail that put in here is not showing up. I'm not crazy, am I? Yeah, so let me show you this T-pose thing. Yeah, so I got this here. Just gonna send it over. So now I go to Z plugin, T-pose subteam right here. And now it's just gonna transfer all that stuff. And then all high. All there. And now I can start making sure everything's like equal distance around the mesh. Relatively, I'm not going to spend, you know, hours and hours. I'm just going to roughly go in here. And you see, I don't go into detail on anything really. Like, even with details, it's just like broad strokes. And then, I don't know. That's just the way I think sculpture is, and very broad strokes at all times. I think I'm gonna auto group these and then use my move topological so I can just get one of these straps at a time and I don't have to worry about masking anything. Oh my god. Oh my god, oh, you're like, oh, you're talking about the mask. And I'm like, yes, I'm talking about the fucking mask! Yes, nose is okay. The mask is what I've been talking about. bring this down. Oops, no, I don't want to go on the negative. Go on the positive. We got that in there, so we can make this this thing a bit wider, actually. Okay, so hopefully he's fixing the situation. He's asking him now, because if I gotta refine that nose, just let me know, dude. Let me know. This, like, Batman sculpt is so fucking important to me. So incredibly important to me. Not just, like, professionally, but emotionally. This thing is very important that comes out. That when I look at this thing, it's fucking beautiful every time I look at it. Because if it's not, dude, oh man, that's gonna crush me, dude. Like, I've been sending them pictures of, like, this thing for I don't know how long. Like drawings, like draw overs, like I do for my students. Like, hey, this area right here needs to be improved. And he's like, oh, no. Oh, okay, I'll let him know. And he's like, they say that the nose is fine. I'm like, dude. Oh my god, that's all right. That's all right. You need to get over it, you know? Just need to get over it. Alrighty. So now let's take a look. Turn it. And let's get this coat, see what we can do with it. little bit more meat here. The amount of polys that are in here is probably why it's giving us those weird deformations. So just give it a little bit more breathing space, and we should get a little smoother transition. Julio Rojas, thank you for following. I appreciate it. Yeah, but I need to stop getting that emotional about being misunderstood. I don't know. Let me get that in check a little bit more. It's hard, dude. It's hard whenever you're passionate about something, you know? I don't know. Maybe that's what separates. I mean, it's not anger that separates, you know, the great from. Or the legendary ones, you know, from the great ones. But do you think an amount of passion, an amount of, like, I will not accept anything less than this, and I will protest and protest and protest until it gets done the way it should be done? I think there's something to be said about having that type of attitude. In these type of situations. Right, and the where it's curved right here is where we need to actually move it up a bit more. It should be just a little bit longer. Right, it should bend that way, because whenever you bend your finger, like, it's roughly at that angle. It's not straight, right, across. Straight across from the knuckle line. Something to be said about having a skater die attitude. You know what I mean? You know what I mean, bro? And we're not going to see most of this, but just so it just looks clean. Oh no. There we go. That looks much better. Alright, so we can kind of move things. We know we need to have. Probably need to rotate this hand a bit as well, so we should do that. Finger. Let's just give a little character to this bit. It's not bad. Not bad for being 4 hours. What? 5-6 hours in. I think we're doing fantastic. Okay, so go here. I'm gonna fix this little impression. Oop. And then I'm going to auto group this as well. So I can just work on the sleeve. And we're going to smooth that out. And I'm going to get form soft and fill that area in. Smooth it out, fill it in. This hand, kind of relax it a bit, and the hands look kind of realistic right now. We're gonna fix that, but again, I just wanted to set it up like that. But we can always stylize it at any time just by taking away things or emphasizing the major angles of it all. Why do I suddenly have 12 messages? Okay, before this gets out of hand, because it's saving this Batman here too, so I'm gonna save this file out before we get too far, and then gonna restart ZBrush. Save this out. And this one is post 01. This, okay, he's leaning a bit that way. Let's give him some perspective, maybe. Oh, yeah, he does have perspective. Okay. So. So just taking into account things I want to fix. But overall, I'm pretty satisfied with how it's looking so far. And maybe not have this line so straight, right? It's ever so slightly off. Right, we don't want things to line up too perfectly. It's not. I mean, if we're doing mechanical engineering, then that would make sense. But if we're doing organic stuff, man, we got to make sure it feels alive. Right? That's what organic sculpting's all about. Natural, organic experiences. this little bopper is going in a bit too much, at least for my taste. So I'm gonna try to fix that. It's a little local symmetry and try to have that come out. Yeah. That looks better. Not too bad. I don't want to put any lines in here because of the, you know, the UV map's going to be like 4096. And with this type of thing, I can kind of get probably a better look with just texturing. So, not worried about the details. Like, even this thing is, I don't know, no me gusto, but whatever. This little bandage thing here doesn't really scream super sexy to me. Increase polygrams. Let's group by normals. Do I have that here? Visual group by polygroups group by normals, and then increase. There we go. A little bit like that, so then we can kind of judge. And then we can divide it and like smooth out the side so it's not so angular. Be that difficult. Okay, that looks sexier to me. Just a little bit sexier. There we go. That looks sexy.
Looks a little bit sexy over here. You know what I'm saying? Tell me what we can do. Over here. We can start making this a little bit colorful, eh?
Alright, so let's get some. Oh, let's get this whole.
A little bit right here. This whole. Oh, what the fuck?
There, add that little bump. Right there. but we can't just have it stop somewhere, right? It needs to go somewhere and do something. We can't just, oh, there's a wrinkle, you know. It either ends in a triangle, or it continues around and makes a form. But it doesn't just stop. Mark this off first, because I think I'm getting confused. If everything's too long. Let's see. The fingers here are a little bit too long, but that's fine. Just needs to be thicker, obviously. Really, really thin hands. Or thin fingers to the hand. Need to fix that shape. Probably enlarge these feet. And really emphasize this piece right here. That's the reason I like posing things, because it just starts revealing a lot of the things that you need to fix, like widening that face a bit. Straight angle here. So
I am going to move that in place. Yeah, and probably this stripe down here and around is probably going to be a texture as well. I'm not really concerned about maintaining it at all. But I do like the happy accent that happened back here, this little shape in the back. It makes sense, you know, if you're going to have a backpack, that you would have a wider piece back here, you know, to cushion it. So, I love happy accents. And we're gonna really hit this little elbow right here, so I'm gonna go down subtive and just right here. Not very sexy. I'm gonna try to build it up so it's a softer transition with just a little hint of a fold. It actually comes all the way down, doesn't it? I'm gonna start giving him some flag colors. So I can take a look. I'm gonna desaturate that just a bit. It's not so aggressive. And color the object, and let's do the same over here. And roughly just get in there. It doesn't need to be perfect. Get this blue in here. Fleshy color. And let's just give him, I think it's blue eyes is what he has.
Dum, 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 dum.
Gray blue, I guess. Yeah. Okay. Let's fix his face real quick. So we'll get to our symmetry, BST, and turn RGB on, Z add off, and turn lazy mouse off as well. And let's see if we can get a drag, and see if we can get something like that. Yeah, I think that'll be better. And let's see if we can change this alpha a bit to be a little bit harsher. Negative 15 on the blur. Intensity, maybe not that much. Yeah, we'll keep that. We'll kick up the blur. Yeah, that's what we're doing. Ready? So we're going to get. Yeah, just a little bit darker, a little bit more green, a little bit more desaturated. Oh, a little bit darker. There we go. Let's see. Nope, too large. Black, but very close to it. And then roughly get our cursor the size of this cornea, and then just get in the center and drag it out. Maybe a little bit off. Okay for right now. I'm not super happy with it. Grab this and just widen it out a bit. Things are pretty good. Oh, let's get this. There. Okay. Oh, and the boots. Boots. These. We can get these. What was that color? Let's get some brown tips. Let's see. Well, actually, it's kind of like that, but a bit more desaturated and a little bit darker. Let's just fill that object. And this is skin color. A little brighter, more desaturated. There we go. Mask by intensity. Go here to masking, mask by color, mask by intensity. We can get a little bit more saturated on this. Maybe a little bit more red too. Bit darker. You notice I'm not taking straight black for anything, right? Like, really, really don't want to do that. And then we can go here. Good surface. There we go. And these holes, still not sure what we're doing with that. We'll figure it out for sure. I think today this is enough sculpting. Yeah? Enough sculpting for today. Okay, so put in another 4 hours today, so we're pretty much around 8 hours on this guy, somewhere around there. So we got a lot of things to fix, which will be revealed to us tomorrow, I'm sure, after taking a break from this guy. Usually, like, fresh eyes really, really help, so I do suggest stepping away from your work after, you've done enough. To step away from, but we've pretty much blocked out this guy today. Mm-hmm. There's plenty to do with the fingers and all that. Actually, I'm gonna go through here and tag those right now. Much better. Get these fingers here. Something like that. But yeah. Good start. Good start. I'm going to put him on a little pedestal so he's just not floating out in the middle of nowhere. And that. Just gonna get this circle 3D. and going to rotate it 90 degrees. And BZM. Hover over a face, all polygons. Let's give it a little bit of thickness. Something like that, you know. There's plenty to fix in terms of the parallel nature of these. We can fix it that easy. But yeah. In terms of block out, I'm done with this. Everything after this is just easy street, really. Not really concerned with any of that. But yeah. Hope you enjoyed the stream. Thank you for watching. And we will be back tomorrow. Oh my god, I forgot my coffee. Had to put that back in the microwave. But thank you for watching. Make sure to follow me everywhere under Shotgun Scream. Make sure to look me up on Instagram under SpicerCG. Make sure to follow the YouTube for all my how-tos and all that good stuff. All my tutorials and stream recaps. Make sure to do that, alright? And thank you for watching. Have a good night.